Hello students, welcome to the online lectures of Kids Planet High School. This lecture is for Standard 8, Subject, English, Chapter, Dick Whittington and His Cat. Let us now begin. Students, the story which you are going to study today is about Sir Richard Whittington, who became the Mayor of London. Let us study about his childhood and how his cat helped him in becoming the mayor of the city London. There was once a poor boy called Dick Whittington who lived in a small village in the south of England. He had no proper home, for both his parents had died and he was unkindly treated by many of the villagers. One day, Dick overheard someone say that the streets of London were paved with gold, and he decided that he would go there at once and pick his fortune up in the gold pieces from the streets, for he thought people might treat him more kindly if he were rich. So young Dick set out to walk to London. He had not gone far when a man in the cart stopped and asked him if he was running away from home. "I have no home," Dick answered. "I am on my way to London to find my fortune." "I am going to London myself," said the carter. "Jump up here beside me and we will journey together." They arrived in London just before nightfall, and the carter left Dick and made his way to an inn. Poor Dick stood alone and looked around in dismay. There was all the fine gold. All he could see were dirty streets and lots of unfriendly people. He had nowhere to sleep, and in the end he spent the night in the corner of an alley where he hoped he would come to no harm. The next morning, Dick woke up cold, miserable and very hungry. He wandered around begging for food, but again and again people shouted at him, "Go away, you lazy fellow, be off with you," and aimed angry blows at his head. At last, he collapsed in the street and lay there too weak to look further for food. By chance, Dick had fallen in front of a house belonging to a rich merchant called Mr. Fitzwarren. The cook was trying to drive Dick away when Mr. Fitzwarren returned home from inspecting his ships. He stopped and said to Dick, "Why don't you work if you need food?" "I would work," said Dick, "but I know nobody who will give me anything to do." "Take him into the kitchen," Mr. Fitzwarren ordered the cook. "Feed him first and then find some work for him." So Dick was given a home and a living. He had a small corner of the attic to sleep in, and his job was to help the cook with all the pots and pans in the kitchen. Dick's life should have been much better than before, but he still had two difficulties to face. The first was that the attic he slept in was overrun by cats and mice. At night, they scampered all over him and kept him awake. After a time, he solved this problem by saving the few pennies he was paid and buying himself a cat. In no time at all, the cat chased away all the rats and mice, and Dick was able to sleep peacefully. The other difficulty, which was not so easy to overcome, was the cook's bad temper. She shouted and screamed all day and would scold Dick and hit him with a wooden spoon, even when he was working as hard as he could. One night, Dick decided he could stand it no more. Early the next morning, before the cook was up, he set out with his cat to seek his fortune elsewhere. The two of them walked as far as Holloway on their way out of London. Then Dick sat down on a stone to rest. It was the 1st of November, All Saints' Day, and the church bells were ringing. As Dick sat and listened, it seemed they were ringing out a message for him. "Turn again, Whittington, though worthy citizen, Lord Mayor of London." "Lord Mayor of London," said Dick. "I should like to be Lord Mayor and ride in a fine coach. I can put up with a few scoldings from the cook if that is what is in store for me." So Dick and his cat retraced their steps to Mr. Fitzwarren's house. Luckily, they were able to slip back before they had been missed. Now, Mr. Fitzwarren used to send ships far across the sea to trade with other countries. He would load a ship with goods from the captain and ship's crew to sell in faraway places, and then they would bring back goods that could be sold at home. One day, he called his household together. "I am sending a ship to the African coast to trade," he said. "Would any of you like to send something of yours on it? You can then share in the profits if the voyage is successful." Everyone produced something except for Dick, who had nothing to offer. "Have you nothing of your own, Dick?" asked Mr. Fitzwarren kindly. And Dick replied, "Only my cat." "Then let your cat go on the ship," said Mr. Fitzwarren. His daughter Alice said, "Dick loves his cat. Let me put something in for him." But her father said, "No, it must be his, not something belonging to someone else." So Dick fetched his cat and said goodbye to it sadly. The captain of the ship was delighted, for the cat was an excellent mouser, and so he had no trouble with rats and mice on his voyage. After some months, the ship arrived at a place on the African coast, Barbary, where people called the Moors lived. The captain sent a message to the king to say he had fine goods for sale, and he was invited to the palace to show them. While he was talking to the king and queen, some dishes of food were brought in, but almost immediately, rats and mice ran up and before the captain's eyes ate all the food. The captain was astonished and asked if this was what normally happened. "Alas, yes," came the reply. "The country is suffering from a plague of rats and mice, and we cannot get rid of them." "I think I may have the answer on my ship," said the captain, and he sent a message asking for Dick's cat to be brought to the palace. More food was laid out, and the rats and mice appeared as before. The cat immediately pounced, killing at least a dozen before they scattered. Everyone was delighted, and the queen asked, "What do you call this animal?" "Puss is the name she answers to," said the captain. And when the queen called, "Puss, Puss," the cat went over to her and purred. The queen was a little alarmed at first, as she had seen how fiercely the cat had attacked the rats and mice. But the captain told her not to be anxious. "Puss is very friendly with people," he said, "and would soon rid your kingdom of rats and mice." "I would give great wealth to own this animal," said the queen. So the captain began bargaining, and it was agreed that the king would buy the whole cargo from Mr. Fitzwarren's ship to pay a fine price for it. And for the cat alone, the king paid 10 times the sum again. When the ship came back to the port of London, the captain showed Mr. Fitzwarren the gold and jewels he had brought from Barbary and told him the story of the cat. The merchant sent for Dick. "From now on, Dick," he said, "we should all call you Mr. Whittington, for you are a rich man." Mr. Fitzwarren then paid him all the money the captain had received for the cat. From this time on, Dick worked with Mr. Fitzwarren and became a successful merchant himself. He married Mr. Fitzwarren's daughter Alice, and 3 times he was elected Lord Mayor of London. He was also, in time, knighted by the king and became Sir Richard Whittington. He was not only famous, but he was popular too, for he always helped the poor with his money. Sometimes, when he was old, he would tell his grandchildren the story of his cat and how the bells of London had called him back when he was only a poor boy. "Turn again, Whittington, thou worthy citizen, Lord Mayor of London,"